Hey, YouTube. I'm back in the country, as you can see my scenery in the background. Excuse me. Anyway, I wanted to talk about cheaters. Cheaters never win. That's right. Cheaters really never win. We're in a society now where people think that if I lie, I could get by. If I cheat on my spouse, I could get by. I'm in this spur of the moment thing and it feels so good. But let me tell you, you will get caught. Somebody will find out. You might not see the results like the day you do the act or whatever it is, but you will get caught. Now, what's the definition of cheating? Well, say for instance, if you're married and you're lusting after someone, it's cheating. And then you come home and you have an act with your spouse. You do the normal routine. However, in your mind, you're thinking of this other person. You're cheating because you are not thinking about the spouse at all. Okay, let's say, for instance, if you're on the time clock and you have somebody else log you in or log you out, you're cheating. Eventually you will get caught and fired. I've spoken to someone a couple of weeks back while I was in Cali, and he was saying, "I don't know why they fired me. I don't know why they fired me." Because you cheated them. It's that simple. In relationships, when you wonder, well, why is my husband leaving me? Because you cheated on him. You're gonna get caught, regardless of what you think about it. Cheating is not something that I would advise, especially nowadays, because things are coming back threefold, sometimes sevenfold, and you lose a lot. The consequences are a loss of a lot of things. Excuse me. There's also the idea of people cheating on their taxes. Chocolate people, y'all do it a lot. You claim extra children when you do not have but one or none, expecting to get a big refund. Excuse me, but somebody does have to pay for that. It's not just you getting this big bonus so you can waste it all come February or March. You don't even know the second week in February. You don't even know where the money went. You don't have a grasp of the money because you lied. It's not there. It's not going to stay there because you lied to get it. Cheaters never win. I don't know who thought of it that they do. I don't know who lied to you and said that nothing bad will happen if you do this. They lied. They built up your ego into believing that you could do this and you would be okay and not get caught. I know a couple of people who got caught and went to federal penitentiary. They went to the pen, the federal pen, which is harder to get out than your regular jail system. It really is. There's been times when I have myself been guilty of cheating and I had to suffer the consequences for it. A theft by check is cheating. You're cheating yourself, the bank, and the system in which sets up for you getting caught. All of it is basically you're a liar. Now, you could call me crazy if you want to, but I'm telling you the truth. A liar is a liar, and through that, you will have to suffer the consequences. It may not be the same day that it happens, but eventually down the road, you are going to get caught. You are going to have to face it. You are going to have to tell the truth. Now, if you end up telling a lie, you've continued the cycle of being a liar and a cheater. You guys know how to get back in touch with me. Like I say, I am back here in the country. Yeehaw. And if you have any questions, you know where to reach me. Shawnee Fenderson, the author, on Facebook, Twitter, MayLodi. I am now a official contributor to Yahoo News. Yay! Yahoo News. Anyway, you guys, get yourself together. Things will work out. It takes time, but you have to be willing to put the time into it. It's harder to do wrong than it is to do right. Love you lots. Smooches. Bye.